Namaskaram. In this uninitiated video, we're going to explore about ash gourd or winter melon and why having this is very beneficial for one's energy levels and also for overall health and well-being. So ash gourd or winter melon, as it's commonly called, this is available in many regions of the world, especially in India, China, such countries. This is very commonly available, and you will see that this is coated with like ash kind of substance outside, so which is why it is called as ash gourd. And in yoga, as you must be aware of, we look at foods in terms of positive pranic, negative pranic, or zero pranic. Positive pranic substances are those which increase the life energy or prana in the system, and they should be consumed on a regular basis. Negative pranic substances, they decrease the life energy and they should be avoided. And zero pranic, neither increase nor decrease, they are neutral. So among the positive pranic foods, one of the most highly positive pranic foods is ash gourd or winter melon. So that is one of the reasons why it is suggested to have ash gourd as part of your daily diet. So there are many benefits of having ash gourd. So this is predominantly about 96% of it is water, and it has many benefits. It has a lot of minerals, and in terms of nutrition, it can do wonders to your health. So how you can have ash gourd is, there are many ways. You can make a juice out of it, and you can also add it to salads. You can make sweets out of it. So basically, or you can make smoothies, etc. So since this doesn't have much of a taste on its own, this can easily blend with anything else. So one thing we generally suggest for people, especially on the yogic path, is to have ash gourd juice on a daily basis. First thing in the morning, if you have ash gourd juice, you will see that it will energize you, but it won't leave you agitated or, especially like coffee. For example, coffee, if you have early in the morning, it will definitely energize you. But the after effects of coffee can be easily felt. It will make you jittery. So this is something, which will energize you, make you much more alert, but you will not have those side effects. So this is one of the best things which you can have in the morning. And especially if you have children at home, it's really, really beneficial that they have ash gourd juice on a daily basis. So see if you can include this as part of your diet. It cleanses the system, and if you have it in the morning, you will see that it will increase your intellectual awareness as well. So generally it was considered that people who have ash gourd regularly, it can enhance their intelligence, and this was something which was considered one of those foods which people thought it has a lot of pranic energy, or positive pranic energy, and that is why they also used it for many other things as well at home. For example, you must have seen this whenever you do an inauguration, especially in Indian homes. You will see that whenever you inaugurate a home, you usually find an ash gourd hanging at the entrance of the door, or they will break the ash gourd in the inauguration ceremony or something like that. Because one of the reasons was because it was considered to have a lot of high pranic energy, and if you use that, it kind of wards off any negative energies, if any, present at home. So it's good if you do that, if you use it for that purpose, but won't it be even better if you put it inside your stomach? So that is the reason why we are suggesting to have ash gourd on a daily basis. So if you have this ash gourd juice, another advantage you will see is that it cools down your system tremendously. It energizes your system and also cools down your system. So so if you are having excess heat in your system, or heat related problems like constipation, boils, or similar problems, piles, so these are heat related problems. So if you are having such kind of problems also, it can help by consuming ash gourd juice, because it will cool down the system. If you are having problems like asthma, sinus, cold, where you tend to catch cold easily, then it's better that when you have ashgar juice, you reduce the cooling property to some extent by adding pepper or honey to it. If you add a little bit of pepper or honey to the ashgar juice, it will reduce the cooling property to some extent. So if you're susceptible to catching colds, or if you have any in winters, then you can do that. But otherwise in summers, it will go very well. It will cool down the system, it will energize you. So it's something which you can have very easily. We'll also share the ashgar juice making recipe with you along with this video, so you can try this out. It's best to consume ashgar in its raw form for maximum nutrition and energy, but you can also make many other things out of it. For example, in India, they also, especially in the northern part of India, they call it as petha, and it's very, the sweets made out of this are very famous. If you have been to Agra, there one of the most famous specialities is petha, or these sweets made of ashgar. So it can be made into sweets also, it can be made into a halwa or a sweet dish. Many other dishes also you can try out. We'll share a link to an article which includes some of these recipes and you can try them out. You can make ashgar salad. You can try out various ashgar recipes at home. You can definitely do that. But if you can have it in the raw form, or having it in juice form, you will see that will be more beneficial for you. So try this out and see. Everybody at home can benefit from this. See if you can make it a part of your diet. Like first thing, if you're having in the morning, well, before you start your breakfast, just have ashgar juice. That's the best thing. Or at any other time of the day also, if you wish to have, you can have it. Especially in the afternoon, if you're looking for a quick boost in energy levels, you can even have that during that time. So any other time also you can have, but it's best if you have it in the morning. You will see the effect throughout the day. If you have school going children at home, they can take this at in the morning before going to school. Instead of having milk or other products, dairy products, they can have something like this. It'll be very energizing for them and they'll be much more alert and sharp. So try this out and see, and let us know how your experience has been in implementing this. Namaskar.
If you eat food and your body feels very agile and alive, that means it's good food, body is liking it. If you eat something it feels dull, that means it's not liking it, it's having difficulty with it, that's why it feels dull.
Namaskaram. For those of you looking to explore about food in depth, we also have an online program on food called as Ahar. So we have a website called as ahar.yogire.com, which will have more details about this program. If you are looking to grow on the path of yoga, then food is as important as sadhana. So it's very important that you see what kinds of foods to eat which can assist you in this inner journey, and more importantly also how to eat. So we'll be looking at this in depth in this online program, and this can be done from the comfort of your home. From wherever you are, you can log in and do this program. So if you wish to explore this in depth, please log in to our Ahar website and you can see if this is something which can help you take a step towards your inner growth
And we hope that the simple process of eating can also become a stepping stone towards your ultimate well-being. Thank you so much. Namaskaram.